Hello all. So now let's discuss a very important topic, the toxicity of anti-cancer drug or cytotoxic agents. Okay. Now cytotoxic agents are the drugs that kill any rapidly dividing cell. Okay. They kill any rapidly dividing cell. Now this cell could be a cancerous cell, hence they are anti-cancer drug. But we know that in our body there are normal cell division also. So they will kill all those cells which are normally dividing as well. So toxicities of anti-cancer cell, we will make a summary of it. Okay. So toxicity of anti-cancer drug, we will write, they are divided into two. Either certain common toxicity, which is seen with almost all anti-cancer drug. And then we will be discussing about characteristic toxicity of certain anti-cancer drug. Okay. Characteristic toxicity. So let's talk about first common toxicity of all anti-cancer drug. So try to identify the normal, the cells which in our body are normally rapidly dividing cells. Okay. So let's write those cells which are normally very rapidly dividing in our body cell. They are also killed by cytotoxic agent. So let's write their common toxicity. You'll write a mnemonic, Bharat Mata. Okay. Now, the first common toxicity is known as bone marrow suppression. Okay, bone marrow suppression. Now this bone marrow suppression is the most important dose limiting toxicity. Now dose limiting toxicity means because of the fear of bone marrow suppression, we cannot give high dose of anti-cancer drug and sometimes we have to stop them also. Okay, with M you will write mucus ulcers. Because mucosal cells are also normally rapidly dividing, which occurs in GIT. Then you will write hair cells because they are also rapidly dividing and growing, alopecia. Then you will write, they are teratogenic because fetal cells are also rapidly dividing cells. And lastly, you will write, they cause azoospermia or an ovulation because the germ cells or gonadal cells, sperms and ova, they are also rapidly dividing cells. Okay. Now let's write first about this bone marrow suppression. So bone marrow suppression is seen with all anti-cancer drug. All anti-cancer drug or cytotoxic agent except it is not seen with or very minimally seen with. You'll write VBAC. Okay. The drugs which does not show or very minimal bone marrow sparing action is seen with vincristine. Okay, bleomycin, asparaginase, and chlorambucil. So these are the drugs which does not suppress bone marrow. Okay, now mucus ulcers or GIT ulcers, remember it is the most common toxicity of, it is the most commonly seen with four drugs AFMC, that is alkylating agent. F for 5-fluorouracil, M for methotrexate, and C for platinum compound like cisplatin. Okay, cisplatin. Now the point is, due to mucus ulceration, the patient will present to you with diarrhea. There will be malabsorption, and the patient will have mucus ulcers which can lead to stomatitis. So in mouth, there will be ulcers. Now it also causes alopecia. Alopecia is most commonly seen with vinca alkaloids or vincristine like drugs. Okay, but it is seen with all drugs. All drugs are teratogenic and all drug may cause male insterility, but it is the most characteristic side effect of a drug, one alkylating agent, procarbazine. Okay, it is seen with variety of drug, but what you have to remember is procarbazine. It is very notorious. Okay, alkylating agents. So these are the certain common toxicity of anti-cancer drug. Now what is more important is their characteristic side effect. So certain anti-cancer drug, they show characteristic toxicity. Okay. So let's write the summary of characteristic toxicity. Okay. Let's write the summary. So what we will be doing, we'll make a diagram of it and we will try to identify the common toxicity. Okay, We will try to identify the common toxicity. So suppose this is a human. So let's write the various organs and its toxicity. The first one you will be writing is cerebellar toxicity. Cerebellar toxicity. You know, cerebellum is required for control of balance and coordination. So cerebellar toxicity is very commonly seen with cytarabine, which is also known as cytosine arabinoside. Cytosine arabinoside. Okay. So first toxicity is cerebellar toxicity, and cerebellar toxicity is seen with cytosine arabinoside. Okay. Now, second point you will be writing, certain drugs, they release ADH hormone from hypothalamus. They cause increase in ADH release, which is known as SIADH. That is syndrome of inappropriate ADH secretion from hypothalamus. So they increase ADH level. So the drugs which increases ADH level are, you will write vinca alkaloids, like vincristine, vinblastine, etc. Any drug which start with the word vin. Okay. Then you will write taxanes. So any drug which ends with the taxane ends with the word taxil, like paclitaxel, docetaxel, etc. And the last drug you will be writing is cyclophosphamide. Okay, cyclophosphamide. So these drugs, they cause SIADH. Okay, so these drugs, they cause SIADH. Vinca, taxane, and cyclophosphamide. Then you will be writing, there are certain drugs which are ototoxic. Okay, so among ototoxic, you have to remember two drugs, that is cisplatin and cyclophosphamide. And here only you will write in medulla, cisplatin causes vomiting. So this drug, cisplatin and cyclophosphamide, are also most emetogenic anti-cancer drug as well. You can write it is the most emetogenic anti-cancer drug also. Maximum nausea and vomiting. And if you want to compare them, maximum nausea and vomiting is by cisplatin, even more than cyclophosphamide. Okay, let's move forward. Let's make an organ heart. In heart, the main toxicity is cardiotoxicity. Cardiotoxicity is produced by the drugs which end with the word rubicin. Any drug which end with the word rubicin will produce cardiotoxicity. Example, doxorubicin. Okay, doxorubicin. So they mainly produce cardiotoxicity. This group of doxorubicin is known as anthracycline group. And remember, this doxorubicin has one more name. Doxorubicin is also known as adriamycin. So any drug which ends with the word rubicin, because they are red colored, they affect a red color organ, heart. Okay. Now let's talk about lungs. In lungs, there are certain drugs which causes pulmonary fibrosis. So pulmonary fibrosis. Okay. So pulmonary fibrosis is a characteristic toxicity in the lungs, which is produced by, you will write three drugs mainly. There are a variety of drugs, but you have to remember three drugs. BBM. That is busulfan, bleomycin, and mitomycin. Okay, mitomycin is known as mitomycin C. So these drugs, they produce pulmonary fibrosis. Okay, let's move forward. Let's talk about a liver. In liver, the certain drugs, they produce hepatotoxicity or liver failure. There are variety of drugs, but characteristic, it is the side effect of methotrexate. Okay, you'll write 6-mercaptopurine and 6-thioguanine. 6-thioguanine. Now remember, there is one drug which inside the body gets converted into 6-mercaptopurine. It is not an anti-cancer drug, But its active form is 6-mercaptopurine. It is rather used as an immunosuppressive drug for organ transplantation and autoimmune condition, that is azathioprine. So these are the drugs which causes hepatotoxicity. Let's move forward. There are certain drugs which will produce nephrotoxicity. Okay, nephrotoxicity. Nephrotoxicity is the characteristic side effect of a drug known as platinum compound like cisplatin. It is a characteristic side effect of a drug known as platinum compound known as cisplatin. Okay, nephrotoxicity. Then you will make a bladder. In bladder, remember there is a side effect known as hemorrhagic cystitis. So there will be damage of bladder, there will be hematuria and inflammation of bladder, hemorrhagic cystitis. Hemorrhagic cystitis is a characteristic side effect of cyclophosphamide. And the brother of cyclophosphamide, ifosfamide. It is an alkylating agent, okay? So it is a characteristic side effect of hemorrhagic cystitis is of cyclophosphamide and ifosfamide. Then you will write, there are certain drugs which will show peripheral neuropathy. Peripheral neuropathy, which is also known as neurotoxicity. Neurotoxicity is the characteristic side effect of vinca alkaloid, especially vincristine. And it is also the characteristic side effect of taxanes like paclitaxel, docetaxel, etc. Okay? Okay, paclitaxel and docetaxel. So this is known as peripheral neuropathy. Okay, so they may cause all types of neuropathy, that is sensory, motor and autonomic. Vincristine produces a very side effect, characteristic side effect known as foot drop due to damage of common peroneal nerve. And taxanes, they also produce Glovestock neuropathy. Okay, it produces Glovestock neuropathy. Then you will write a side effect which is seen in palms and soles only. The side effect which is seen in palms and soles is known as hand foot syndrome. Because these drugs, they are excreted out in sweat, and through sweat they will be deposited in palms and soles, because maximum sweating occurs in palms and soles. This is known as hand foot syndrome. Okay. Now this hand foot syndrome is a characteristic side effect of, you will write 5-fluorouracil, and the prodrug of 5-fluorouracil which inside the body will be converted into 5-fluorouracil, that is capecitabine. Okay, it is also seen by many other drugs like p-metrix, but what you have to remember is first two drug. It is also seen with adriamycin, but what you have to remember is first two drugs. Okay, 5-fluorouracil and capecitabine, they cause hand foot syndrome. And lastly, you will write, there is a skin rashes. That skin rashes condition is known as hemolytic uremic syndrome, hemolytic uremic syndrome, thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura. Okay, hemolytic uremic syndrome, thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura, it is seen with a drug known as mitomycin C. It is seen with a drug known as mitomycin C. Hemolytic uremic syndrome, thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura. So these are the certain characteristic toxicity of anti-cancer drug. Okay, this is the characteristic toxicity of anti-cancer drug. Okay, now just write certain antidotes here only. Let's write certain antidotes. Remember, to treat this nephrotoxicity due to cisplatin, the antidote is one drug, antioxidant drug, amifosgene. Okay, to treat nephrotoxicity due to cisplatin, we use amifosgene. To treat hemorrhagic cystitis due to cyclophosphamide and ifosfamide, we use an antidote which can be given orally as well as IV, that is Mesna. We give an antidote, Mesna. And to treat this cardiotoxicity due to doxorubicin and Rubicin-like drug, the antidote is one iron chelator known as dexrazoxane. This is the antidote. Okay, to treat cardiotoxicity, we give dexrazoxane. To treat nephrotoxicity, we give amifosgene. To treat hemorrhagic cystitis, we give Mesna. Okay, now these drugs are given IV, while Mesna can be given orally as well as IV, both. Okay, Mesna can be given orally as well as IV. So this is the summary of the characteristic toxicity of anti-cancer drug. Okay, this is the characteristic toxicity of anti-cancer drug. So this is a very important point and you must remember. So hope you enjoyed this lecture. So thank you very much.